good, everybody? Welcome to an epic My Damn Toys video. Today, ladies and gentlemen, I am going to be showcasing My Damn Toys, or MDT's, WWE action figure parking lot brawl slash garage slash whatever the hell you want to call this, the entrance to your MDT or WWE figure arena right here. You guys can see what we got going on right here. Very cool, especially if you get from certain angles. I think it looks super badassery, but I'm going to show you guys exactly how to build this thing, you know, all the things I used in this, everything, you know, where you can get it, you know, everything like that. So let's go ahead and get started. You could obviously use this for your pick feds. You can use it for your just arena. You know, some people just have your arena set up if you want to use it as an accent to your, you know, your WWE figure backstage. This is an excellent way to accent that. You know, this is your little entrance door over here. But I guess we can start off on the left side and we'll work our way back, and then we'll cover everything in between. You know, the biggest thing is keeping it contained, unless you have a really big area, you know, with like some concrete or something. Mine works out great because I have this table. I actually have these two tables that are like 6 feet long, and me and my dad actually like had to cut them up so that they would fit securely against the wall. This is, of course, my back wall where my figures are. My computer's up here to the right here, but it kind of blends in, so it kind of works out. But anyways, this works out great for me because this table is gray, or both these tables are gray, and obviously concrete and, you know, usually garages or parking lots and stuff like that are usually this gray tone. You guys go inside of a parking deck or whatever, usually the floor looks like this, or it'll be like a gray cement color because obviously it's poured cement is basically what it is, and then they usually have painted lines. There's no painted lines on here. You could easily paint some arrows or something if I wanted, add some stickers or something, but that is not what we got going on. We got the gray floor here for the concrete base or whatever for our parking lot garage. So we're going to start over here on the left, guys. All right, so we start over here. You guys will see Corey Graves guarding the door. Now, obviously, this could work as security or whatever the hell you want to do, but you can put a suited figure right here. You can put your big boss man, whatever you want to put right here. You can even use your Hopper from Stranger Things to work as your, you know, your freaking, your security guard to the entrance of your building. So right here we have the entrance of the building. Over here you have the high voltage signs and stuff like that. If you guys are wondering where I got this piece right here, this cardboard piece here and this piece up here, this is actually from extremesets.com. You can use the promo code MDT. You'll save 15%. They got all kinds of great backgrounds on there. Not only do they have the backstage for wrestling figures, they have other ones like little street dioramas. They have like underground stuff. They have some really badass stuff over there. So extremesets.com, promo code MDT, save yourselves 15%. But that's what we got this right here. It's an older one. This is the version 1.0. They have a version 2.0 that I have in my backstage area, but this is the 1.0. I think the 2.0 is a little bit higher up, a little bit higher quality, and a little bit more detailed, but it worked for this because I didn't want to move all my other crap out of there. But anyways, you have your front door right here. In the 2.0, actually, these doors open. On the 1.0, however, these do not open, but I'm not really worried about that. So I have this as my entrance to the arena right there. And then we have the NXT guardrail playset that you can get at ringsidecollectibles.com. If you can't find it on Ringside Collectibles, you can go to eBay to find that. But ringsidecollectibles.com, where you can grab this right here. You can also grab these chairs and this table and use promo code MDTOYS to save 10% if you want to pick up the guardrail set or the tables or the chairs. You just go to Wrestling Figures Accessories. They should be listed on there somewhere. But you guys know when you enter a building, usually you have your security here at the end of your walkway. So this is where the wrestlers would get in their vehicles, pull up right here, get out, get their bags and shit, walk down the little aisle here, you know, check in right here. Are you on the list? Whatever, you'll get into the building, go to your locker room, whatever the hell. So that is that right there. You got your guardrails that sort of separate everything right here. I thought about putting another one here because you'd have to go around, but obviously the table ends, so I'm not worried about that. You also have a referee right here at the beginning. I don't know why, I just figured he'd be here. And we have a vindication match taking place right here, so just a little heads up. So where are we? Okay, I guess I can get into this gym bag right here. So the gym bag is just a little accessory to throw in there, you know, a little piece of dog trash right there that you can throw in. Gives it more details, gives it a little bit more lively feel. You can get that. That's a Jax accessory. I don't think that Mattel has given us a bag or a gym bag like that. You can get that on eBay. Just type in WWE Jax gym bag or WWE figure gym bag. Something like that should come up. It may have a WWF logo on it from back in the day, but that's a good one right there. This right here, honestly, you know, this doesn't even have to be here. This is actually my Royal Rumble stands that were against that wall already, and they were here, so I just sort of played off of them, and it actually worked out great. So even if these weren't here, you could easily have this piece right here. This black paneling could sit right there, and it would blend in well. This is like an interview area for WWE superstars or wrestling action figures, so that would work as a background piece anyway, or you could use another hallway piece from the Backstage 2.0 or 1.0, which does come together, so I mean, that's whatever. I just thought that fit because, I don't know, it just kind of blends in well if you want, and the wrestlers could get up there and jump off or whatever. If you guys notice these steel beams right here, I think those come with one of the Mattel entrance stages, and I just had them laying around, so I just sort of stuck them there. They just kind of blend in and just seem like they fit, especially from an angle like this. So that pretty much does it for this area. If we go over here behind the referee, you guys will see we have our trash can and our recycle bin. I did a full video on these if you want to check those out on the channel. I got them for, I think, $11 to $13 on Amazon, shipped to your door. Very, very great. They're, you know, they have operational wheels. You can open them up. You can put stuff down in them, and they come with these little stickers, obviously. Got trash right there. Only thing we're missing is Trash Corbin, so you can easily get the recycle bin and the trash can from Amazon. Adding to the details of the parking garage slash whatever the hell you want to call this, we do have our ladder, which you can get from Ringside Collectibles as well. That is just a little steel cage piece from an old playset as well, so that's the biggest thing when you're doing backstages, when you're doing little things like this to try to make, you know, your illusions, because it looks like this is enclosed. Like, it looks like this is a real-life action figure setup, when really I just took a bunch of pieces, put them all together, and it looks, you know, it brings the whole look all together. So the little stage or the little stage pieces over there, and then we have the little steel cage playset. Just use your WWE figure playsets, put them together. You can find some really cool things. We have another steel beam right here, which matches the ones that are over in that corner. I just thought it really tied in. You know, it kind of just fits into the whole theme of the piece, and it blends in well. So for this back wall, which is this big, tall gray wall with the red line going through it, works great as a background image for a parking lot or whatever. It just is a neutral gray. It's a little darker than the floor, so it really blends in well. That also comes with the Extreme Sets. You can get that at ExtremeSets.com. That is the 2.0 backstage set, and I think that's actually supposed to go on the floor of your backstage, but I always use that piece as my background. It comes with two, and I always just stack them up right there. I don't know what it is, but one of them's a little bit taller, or they just didn't line up the red line right there. I think that's supposed to be where they run the cords, or it's like the little steel part where it separates on the floor. I don't know, but they're supposed to go on the floor, and the superstar's supposed to walk on them. I always put them up in the background because they work perfectly like so, and I don't know. They've always worked for me that way, so there's that. So coming into the last most important piece of a parking lot or a street or a parking lot brawl, or, you know, the WWE figure arena parking lot, whatever the hell you want to call this thing, is your vehicles. I mean, you got to have vehicles, right? We also have a couple of the guardrails in the back right here, which is where my computer is. And it kind of just looks like it goes into the street, especially my, you know, what would you call it? The brains of the operation of the computer here. This is basically the computer. The rest is just the monitor. There you have my mic as well. But, you know, the cutoff is kind of right here. And so we have our vehicles. You have the Wreckin Slammobile from Mattel, which is a, I don't think it's a Target exclusive. It may be a Target exclusive, but you guys know with Braun Strowman and things like that. We've used this in the Pick Fed before. We've used this in action figure matches and stuff like that. So we do have this car here, and this is actually made by Mattel. This truck back here is not made by Mattel one bit. I don't know who made this. It's like Driven or something like that made this, and it scales pretty well. You know, it's not perfect by any means, but it gets the job done. I feel like it blends in really well. Obviously, if this door opened, you couldn't put a superstar in it, but I feel like up next to the car, it pretty much works. Like, I don't know. I feel like it's better for pictures, maybe, and like pick feds and stuff. You know, I don't think it's in complete scale. I feel like it needs to be maybe 20% to 25% a little bit larger to fit. This right here is literally nothing. I don't know why that's there, but it kind of looked cool. Kind of looks like a parking brake or something. So I just left it there. So there's that. But all this works out, man. I think it's a really cool idea. I would love to, if you guys make your own, I would love for you guys to post them up to you. I want to get, you know, some figures in here. Let me go ahead and grab a couple guys. So you do have John Cena and the Ryback right here in the backstage area. Again, like with the cars and stuff, obviously with the Wreck and Slammobile, you can break the windshield, you can break the seats, the doors, the trunk, you got the hood there. You can do this truck has some operations and stuff like that. You can obviously do all kinds of stuff. And the biggest thing with creating things like this is the creativity behind it. And I just thought it was really cool, especially when you stand back and it gives you that really good optical illusion where it looks like it's all contained. I think that's what makes it the best. And especially if you're in here filming and stuff, I mean, this looks so cool with the background and the accessories and everything. Really brings it together, brings it to life. And since I had to put this up for a match for Hell's Gate and I was completely finished with that match and everything, I wanted to make a video out of it. So now we're very close, guys. We're so freaking close that I can taste it. We're so freaking close. All I got to do really is edit the show, which is going to take me a minute, but you know what? We're going to get there. So that is going to do it for today's video, guys. Thank you so very much for watching. Hope you guys did enjoy. Again, if you make your own backstage area or your own parking lot or whatever, let me know down in the comment section below. Also, tag me on Instagram or something. If you create it and post it up, go ahead and tag me and I will like it and comment on it and give you feedback on it. But that is going to do it for today's video, guys. Thank you so very much for watching. I hope you guys did enjoy. Subscribe to the channel. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at MyDamnToys, and I will see you guys in the next video. Thank you.